Hi, I'm Corey Siegel. I'm the section chief for gastroenterology, hepatology, and we take care of patients with gastrointestinal disorders and liver diseases, and I work with a great group of colleagues here at Dartmouth-Hitchcock Medical Center. I can really reassure our patients that we are doing everything we can to make sure that we take care of them while they're safe at home by bringing them into the hospital only when they really need to, and we're available and we're here to see them if that's the case. As many departments and sections in the hospital, we've had to make a lot of adaptations to our usual business, and we all had to do it very, very quickly. I'm proud to say that we really were one of the early adopters of telemedicine. It's something that we've been involved with for a while in gastroenterology, so we were pretty much ready to go as this pandemic started to become real for us here. And I think the one benefit we've received from this, if anything, is that we've learned that telemedicine is a great way to deliver care. And we've already heard from not just patients, but also my colleagues, our providers, that this is a great way to deliver care. And people are already asking if we could even continue doing this after we're through this crisis. We, of course, do a lot of procedures and endoscopy, both upper endoscopies, colonoscopies, and other procedures that, of course, we've had to make a big transition there. And at first, we really made this only for patients coming in with life-threatening emergencies to come to the hospital so that we can keep everybody at home as much as possible. But as we realize that we're developing a safer environment here to care for patients, we're able to slightly open this up a little bit more and let patients in who really are sick and need to come and see us. We recognize there's a whole group of people out there who it's not life-threatening right now, but it can be if we wait too long, so we want to bring them in. So instead of saying elective, we've been trying to use the term time-sensitive, that we really want to get you in as soon as possible, and we've created a safe environment to allow that to happen. We're slowly letting people in, not opening floodgates, getting a busy hospital all of a sudden. And I think if all the departments keep doing what they're doing, which is very thoughtfully and individually selecting patients who we believe it's safe to bring in and it's important to bring in, and if we do that in a careful manner, I think we could really help our patient population by bringing those in whose health really depends on it. As this starts to unfold, so many questions are out there that need to be answered. So we've been involved in a couple of ways already. There's a national registry of patients with COVID-19 in the United States looking to understand what GI symptoms might be associated. And it was noted early, even in China, that there are gastrointestinal symptoms that people develop with COVID-19. So we're part of monitoring that in our patients here and seeing how we can contribute to the learning. Furthermore, we've been involved in inflammatory bowel disease work, and particularly is my expertise and specialty, and quickly recognized that our patients had so many questions about how to manage their inflammatory bowel disease symptoms during this pandemic. And I was fortunate to work with colleagues from the International Organization for IBD to spearhead a project to develop recommendations of how exactly we should manage our patients with inflammatory bowel diseases. And now this has been published in record time so that all patients and my colleagues out there can see what the recommendations are from this international group of IBD specialists so that we can give guidance to our patients. And the advice I can give to either our patients with GI symptoms or people who we haven't met yet with GI symptoms is that we're open for business and we're really busy in the telemedicine space. We have clinics going every day with multiple providers. We're seeing somewhere between 40 and up to 70 patients a day with telemedicine visits. So the advice I can give to patients is simply to contact us and call us.